Hi, I'm Emma, and I'm one of the NIHR SPHR pre-doc fellows based in Newcastle at Fuse. And my ResNet project is looking at access to community mental health and addiction supports for service users with severe multiple disadvantage and service providers. So the project's possible because I have a lot of collaborations in place with folks from Newcastle University and Fuse, UCL, the University of Bristol, Fulfilling Lives, Crisis, and Groundswell. So a bit of background. We know that the Northeast of England experiences some of the greatest austerity and health inequalities in the entire country, and that's not new to the pandemic. At sort of the most extreme end of disadvantage are individuals who experience a combination of homelessness, mental ill health, substance use, and offending. And this group of people, people have used a variety of terms to describe them. Some of them include multiple complex need, multiple exclusion homelessness, or severe multiple disadvantage. And that's the term I tend to use. So there was a mapping exercise in England for severe multiple disadvantage and found that Newcastle fell into the highest prevalence index and Gateshead fell into the second highest. So we know that there are people experiencing this problem in the area. For people that fall in the category of severe multiple disadvantage, they sort of have higher rates of mental health conditions and also higher rates of substance use and alcohol problems. But also, and what I think more importantly is, they have really high rates of self-reported mental health problems. They tend to experience a lot of challenges and barriers when trying to access mental health and addiction supports. And that was the case even before the pandemic took place. With COVID-19, everyone's facing new barriers and challenges. And one of the good things that's come from this is that the government's put a bunch of recent policies and initiatives in place to assist people who are homeless and fall in that vulnerable category. But we don't really know what those policy changes have done in terms of access to mental health and addiction. So the aim of my study is to really explore and understand access to community mental health and addiction supports within Newcastle and Gateshead from the perspective of both service users experiencing severe multiple disadvantage and also staff throughout this entire pandemic period. So the methods, it's a qualitative approach, and basically we're doing data collection that's going to be interviews with both service users and service providers. And we're looking at potentially exploring focus groups if that's more appropriate for service providers. We're not going to make decisions on whether or not the virtual or in-person lightly. And those are going to be made with consultation with peer researchers, our local partners, and also being aware of the local pandemic guidelines. From an analysis perspective, we're looking at two different approaches. Thematic analysis is going to be used to explore the collective experiences of service users and providers. And interpretive phenomenological analysis is going to be used to explore the distinct experiences of each group. For PPI, we've really leveraged the local and national homelessness and severe and multiple disadvantage expertise by meaningfully involving Fulfilling Lives, Crisis, and Groundswell, sort of from the point of when we put in this bid, with plans to do this ongoing. And we're currently exploring the best ways to involve peer researchers throughout data collection and analysis. For the broader public and providers, we're looking at running two workshops. And the first workshop is really just meant to get a bit of context into the local environment, understand the research more, and also increase awareness about the study. The second workshop is really going to focus on reviewing the findings and shaping potential dissemination and really understanding how the research we've done could be impacting practice and policy. So finally, just a bit about my outputs and impacts. I've grouped them into four broad groups. So for a systems idea, we're looking at potentially providing a better understanding of access or the lack of access to mental health and addiction supports in the community. For networking, I'm going to increase my network, but also my early career researcher and ResNet member networks from both a research perspective of developing these collaborative networks across the SPHR schools and ResNet members, but also within the research area that we're studying. From a skills perspective, I'm hoping to produce some peer-reviewed publications and evidence for practice guides and conferences, as well as maybe some blogs and potentially media coverage. And then also, I think what's sort of most important is this is giving me a chance to really develop additional skills as a principal investigator for a study. And that involves grant applications, research translations, and sort of PPI more broadly. All these skills are going to be really helpful in sort of meeting my future goal, which is that this research will help inform the development of a doctoral research fellowship application. So that's the end of my presentation. Thank you for your time and attention, and I welcome any questions and comments at this point.